Okay, hello. Welcome to the math vlogs here. And we're still working on systems of equations, two equations to be specific. But the method is new. This is the substitution method. If you think about the word substitution, if I have something to substitute with something else, that's what we have. That's what's happening here. So, what we have are two equations, y equals x minus 2. And 1 second, please. That's better. Now the second equation, which is 3x plus 2y equals 11. Our first goal will be to choose a variable and isolate it, whichever you want. I see here in our example that the variable y in the first equation is already isolated. So, now as I said earlier, the first equation already has one of the variables isolated, the y variable. So that's our first equation. It's already ready. It has y equals something, right? So it's isolated. That's what I said before. Now that y variable, it equals x minus 2. That means if I see a y somewhere else, it equals x minus 2. Now what is the benefit for us? If you see the second equation there, 3x plus 2y equals 11, that y in that second equation, we're going to replace it with x minus 2 because they're equivalent. Let's watch what happens. Now what you see here, as I'm using colors to illustrate my point, that I took the first equation, y equals x minus 2, and substituted for y into the second equation. So where y used to be is now x minus 2. Now I have one equation in one variable, and I can solve for that variable, x. If I had two variables in one equation, I would not be able to solve for that equation. If we have two variables, we need two equations. Three variables, three equations, and so on and so forth. Now we have one equation that we've created and one variable. We can solve for x now. Now I'll stop here for a moment and we can see, where this is back to a single variable, single equation. We have 5x minus 4 on the left and we have 11 on the right, and we'll work down till we get x isolated and it will equal something. So we're going to work on getting rid of the minus 4 and the 5 times x. Excuse me. So here we've divided by 5 here in this last step because we had 5 times x. That's a relationship. Now the inverse of multiplication is division. Okay? When you divide 5 by 5, you get 1. And now we divide by 5 both sides. 15 divided by 5 is 3. Now, this answer for x is solution. We can substitute that back into either equation, number 1 and number 2. Now our goal is to solve for y. For me, the first equation seems simplest to work with. Wow, a lot of writing here, but I'm giving you the steps, it clearly laid out. I forgot to write the second step earlier, so I had to go through the second step, the third step, and the fourth step. Anyways, we isolate, find the answer. We've done that already, step three, which is right here. Now we have one variable and one equation. We solve for that variable. Okay? Now we find the value for x and substitute it in one of the two, either one of the original equations. We need a pair, right? An x and y answer. Now x isn't by itself isn't the full solution. So now this answer for our x and y pairs, 3 comma 1, now this is an answer that we think is correct. We need to check the answer. And if we substitute it in both equations, and both equations are become true, then our answer checks out. I'll do that right now. Now we can see, okay, it's a lot of writing still, but now we have seen our check, and both equations are true. What that means is our pair 3 comma 1 for x and y satisfies both equations at the same time. X does equal 3 and y does equal 1. I tend to box my answer only, my solution, not my checks, not my other intermediate answers. So I know what my answer's boxed, it's correct. I'll use circles or underlines to show other things. Thank you, and see you next vlog.